gonna be a beautiful day.
Everyone's favorite multi-platinum maritime MC is back with his 16th album.
So good. It's called Tomorrow Could Be the Day Things Change. It's the newest drop from Juno Award-winning artist Classified. And we're so grateful he is here this morning because I know you are on tour.
Yes.
And those
That makes it early right now.
It makes it really early.
This is kind of like my late night rather than my early morning.
Have you gone to bed yet?
Yeah, I tried to go to bed early last night, but...
Congratulations on this album number 16.
Thank
and you. You really do breach a lot of important topics that a lot of us are talking about, especially in lieu of the Me Too movement.
Mm-hmm.
So let's tackle some of those issues.
Yeah, like, well, I guess Powerless would probably be the one that, you know, the first single we dropped from the album, which talks about, you know, missing Indigenous women in Canada and abroad, and then, you know, child abuse, stuff like that. People seem to shy away from these topics of music, and with this one, it was something that really, really hit me, like, on a personal level a few different ways. And I wanted to make this, like, the first single just to kind of come out of nowhere and be like, look, let me drop something totally different than what you would expect from a typical Classified first single and try to open up some eyes and open up some conversation.
How do you write about something like that, though? It's a difficult subject.
It is, but it's the same time I find these things are sometimes the easiest to write about because it's so... untapped. No one's ever talking about it. So it's like anything you say, it feels like it's fresh and it's like, okay, I can say this, I can say this. No one else has said this yet. So I found this song very easy to write because it was just exactly what I was thinking about. Just put it on paper and put it down.
And as Raj, you know, you were saying during the commercial break, you're a dad of three beautiful girls. So
yeah.
I imagine that really makes you want to have this change happen soon and fast because we have a lot of work to do.
Totally. But even before that, like, people always ask me, you know, once you had kids and, you know, did you change the way you talk about women and treat women? But I've never been really that guy that's, you know, calling women hoes or whatever you want to say. Like, I've always been, I feel like my parents, totally, yeah. So, but having kids, it definitely changes your values and your, the way you want to spend your time. And, you know, I'm not just on tour to be on tour and hang with the boys anymore. It's here because there's a reason to do it. Because I want to be home as much as I can with the kids as well, so.
Have you written about your girls?
Oh, yeah. I got a song. I write about them all the time. But if I had to pick one that was, like, some real serious, I have a track called Growing Pains. It's kind of like talks about having kids and growing up and how I kind of see it going and hopefully how it's going to turn out.
The album's amazing.
They're under 10 though, right?
Yeah. We'll see how it goes in 5 years.
Yeah, we'll talk then. Yeah.
You have great Canadian collaborations with Anjali and also Tory Lanez, huge fans of both of them too. So how did that come about? Was it something you always wanted to do? Did you have a song in mind and you think their voice will add to it? Or how
does that Tory, that's how it was. I had the track pretty much done and I was trying to find the right chorus for the song.
Hot track.
Tory I met like 9 years ago when he was just on the come up. We did an Echo photo shoot. And I just hit him up after like years of him going around, blowing up around the world, and kind of said, hey man, I got this idea, sent the song, he did it up, which was amazing, you know what I mean? Because we didn't know each other that good, and he was super cool to come back and bless the track. And then with Anjali, she actually wrote that chorus and sent it to me. She was like, hey, this little idea I had, it was just the piano and her voice. I took it in the studio, put some drums on and kind of built around it, yeah.
Now, you are on tour, and you're bringing even more Canadian pals with you.
Yes.
We love them both. Chuck Clare, who's a fan of yours, Roger P.
Follows me on Twitter.
And,
Bragging Rights, and Maestro, who's
Maestro
been on
Fresh
our show
West.
Many times.
Yeah, these are guys that I grew up, you know, idolizing as a young kid, being like, even before it was like Canadian hip-hop, it was just Canadian artists that you saw on Much Music or whatever it was. So these were guys that I grew up idolizing, and to have them guys on the road with us, it's fun. You know, I mean, we just started the tour, but we're having a good time.
Nice.
Check it out, guys. It's called Tomorrow Could Be the Day Things Change. It's very powerful, and you are on tour. So many dates. Make sure you check it out to catch them live. Thank you so much for being here, Classified.
Thank you.
All right, let's head upstairs now to Mel.